What's up? Tom Frumling from Twins Daily here. We're going to talk about this prospect list in a little bit, but first off, let's get into some spring training highlights. First one we're going to roll into here is Trevor Larnach barreling up another ball for an RBI single. He is hitting .381 with a .458 on base percentage and an .810 slugging. So that's a 1.268 OPS so far this spring. Check it out.
And flew home together.
The 1-0 pitch smacked to right center field. A sharp base hit for Larnach. Rounding third is Whitefield. He will score to third. Flores on a line drive missile RBI single for Larnach. It's a 7-4 game.
Boy, Larnach just continues to hit the ball hard.
That was a great swing. Solid, loud contact. A line drive base hit to right center. Tying run now coming up in Caleb Hamilton.
Thank you.
And the really crazy thing about Larnach's success this spring is that he's not even close to the most impressive prospect so far, not even close to the most impressive outfield prospect so far. Alex Kirilloff has been a beast. I'm going to show you a double he hit, an opposite field double he hit this week, but he is hitting 500 with a 529 on base percentage and a 938 slugging percentage. That is a 1.467 OPS so far this spring. Check it out. And I'm going to show you the entire plate appearance here. Actually, he falls behind, fouls away some pitches, really battles in this plate appearances, ended up with a nice double. So check it out.
Old as he came on to run for J.D. Martinez in the 0-1. Ground ball five. And the 0-2. Pitch. Kirilloff socks that one foul. 26-year-old left-hander out of Independence, Missouri. That's where he was born. One, two, a fly pretty well hit on the move. Espin is going to have to play that one high off the monster. And Kirilloff is in the second base with a double. So that's a leadoff two-base hit in the seventh inning. Well, J.D. Martinez.
So we had Kirilloff, the 2016 first-round pick of the Twins. We have Larnach, the 2018 first-round pick of the Twins. Matt Wallner was technically in the first round. He wasn't the Twins' first pick in the draft. He was in the supplemental round. But yet another corner outfielder. This isn't much of a highlight, but this is some defense. He cuts the ball off well and then really flashes his arm. This is a guy who started his collegiate career out pitching. Really good arm. I think he's one of those guys almost a little bit in the Max Kepler build, that he's a lot more athletic than he looks because he's such a tall guy out there. He doesn't really look fast. But I think of all of these, this trio of first-round corner outfielder picks, I think Wallner has the best chance to be a plus defensive outfielder. Check out this play.
Towards the corner, and that will not be tracked down by Wallner. A base hit, trying for two to throw to second base. A good arm back in. And now retreating back to first is Mendoza. So nice arm strength there on display from Wallner. Tracked it down near the line of the right field corner. Quickly got it back in. So with two outs, Mendoza thought about two, but then saw the arm strength of Wallner and retreated back to first. So it's a two-out single. Cardinals by three here in the ninth. And now Mac.
All right, so there was a quick look at a trio of outfielders in this system, and there are no shortage of those guys in the corners. Here's a look at Twins Daily, our combined top 20 prospect list for the season. And as you can see, it's pretty loaded with corner outfield guys. Travis Blankenhorn, he's currently playing a little bit more infield than outfield. I expect that to remain the case, but he may end up in a corner outfield spot. Misael Urbina, we'll call him a center fielder for now. He's like a teenager. His body will kind of dictate where he ends up. Matt Wallner, corner outfielder. As we saw, Celestino's a center fielder. I think he's going to stick there. Brent Rooker has now been kind of transitioned into more of a left fielder than a first baseman. And then, of course, the two big guys, Trevor Larnach and Alex Kirilloff. However, Royce Lewis might even end up in the outfield. He would be definitely a center fielder, a center field caliber player, but he may end up in the outfield. We don't know. May end up at third base. My money would be on the Twins keeping him at shortstop, but a lot of that probably is going to be dictated by who else is in the organization when he emerges, even who's healthy when he emerges. He may end up whenever he comes up, it may be to fill in for somebody. And sometimes when that happens, a guy kind of just sticks in a spot or whatever. So, you know, as we saw with Luis Arraez, came up and impressed, and they even were sticking him in left field basically for the first time in his career, just because he was hitting so well. You got to find a spot for the guy, and there was a need as well. So, if you hear about, you know, that's kind of my take on Royce Lewis, his defensive future. It's probably going to not really depend so much on him as it is the opportunities that are created around him. But main point is there's already a ton of outfielders. Again, I'll circle Urbina and Celestino, even though I think those guys are more center fielders. And you can see there's the top 20 here is just littered with outfielders. You know, obviously this feature is more highlighting the minor league system, but it's undeniable that this kind of outfield depth in combination with, oh, by the way, Byron Buxton, Eddie Rosario, Max Kepler at the major league level. You've got Marwin Gonzalez backing those guys up this year. Jake Cave for, I mean, as long as he's under team control for quite a while. This is certainly a pool of players that the Twins can capitalize on to even further improve this ball club whenever, you know, trade deadline, whatever. So it's pretty good situation to be in. You feel a little bit for the guys like Kirilloff and Larnach, who are lighting it up at spring training and basically have zero chance of that, you know, turning into anything. You know, they could hit, you know, 1,000 from here on out in their opportunities and it wouldn't matter. But as far as for the overall organization, it's a nice thing to see. All right, well, thanks for tuning in. That does it for this week of the Prospect Pulse. We're going to do this every single week. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up. For more Twins content, please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.